Hey folks, last week was chock full of exciting announcements and demos at E3. We were thrilled at the showing of Unreal Engine Teams. There were so many games we can't wait to get our hands on. With over 75 games on display at the show, the annual challenge of selecting our Unreal E3 award winners was monumental. From heavy hitters like Borderlands 3 and the Final Fantasy VII remake to small yet mighty showings from Way to the Woods and Creature in the Well, we had the privilege of speaking to teams of all sizes and going hands-on with many of their passion projects. Dive into our E3 29 recap to find out who's taking home top honors and receiving prizes from our great partners NVIDIA and Intel. Epic Games CTO Kim Libreri is something of a legend in the visual effects industry, with film credits including The Matrix and the Oscar-winning What Dreams May Come. In our latest Virtual Disruptors podcast, FX Guide's Mike Seymour talks with Kim about how virtual production techniques are changing the face of VFX pipelines, how his team has advanced Unreal Engine technology by pushing it beyond its limits on special projects such as A Boy and His Kite, Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice, Meet Mike, Siren, and the new Chaos demo. And they discuss the importance of the annual Real-Time Live. To wrap things up, Kim shares what he believes is next for Epic Games and real-time technology. Listen to the full podcast or read the blog for an overview. We're excited to announce the official launch of the new and improved Unreal Online learning site. Now it's easier than ever to learn Unreal Engine and level up your real-time skills. Whether an advanced UE artist or developer, or you're completely new to the engine, you'll find courses designed to help you get the most out of Unreal at your own pace. Find curated learning paths, earn points, and badges, and more. Check it out and let us know what you think. Released into early access in December, Contractors has become a fan-favorite VR shooter. Developed by the four-person caveman studio, the game features some of the best graphics for a multiplayer VR shooter with polished-looking gun models and a full-body inverse kinematic system coupled with smooth performance. In our interview, the team shares tips on how they achieved the game's high visual fidelity while keeping VR's steeper performance requirements in check, how they designed a shooter around VR's strengths and weaknesses, and more. Formed in a Canadian basement 2 years ago, Vancouver-based PrecisionOS is now a flourishing business that provides orthopedic surgical training in virtual reality. After years at Radical Entertainment, Black Box Games, and the industry giant EA, the team wanted something different. Since making a mistake in the operating room could have significantly grave consequences, the team now helps ensure that orthopedic surgeons get to practice on virtual patients before they operate on real ones. Space sandbox game Astroneer has been a popular indie title that's been in the works for years, and while it has officially launched, System Era Softworks isn't resting on its laurels and plans to continually update and improve the game. We sat down with creative director Adam Brommel and engineer Sam Wolpert to discuss how they designed Astroneer, implemented stylized graphics within a procedurally generated world, and overcame technical challenges over the course of its development. Whether you're training paratroopers to identify reference points for new drop zones or predicting the path of airborne hazards, the accuracy and realism of your simulation is critical. That's just one of the reasons Booz Allen Hamilton turned to Unreal Engine. Learn more about the company's impact on fields from government and defense to healthcare and energy and how they're using Unreal to do so. Now on to our weekly Karma Earners. Many, many thanks to Every Nun, Indie Game Cove, Shadow River, Nebula Games Inc., That Lightworker, T. Sumisaki, Maxim Nositov, Xander Rake, and Ted Undead. If you'd like your shot at your name up here, head on over to AnswerHub and help out your fellow devs. First up on our spotlight lineup is Zed by Eager Games. Zed is the story of an aging artist that is lost in regret and the haze of dementia. Inside the dreamscape of this creative mind comes undone, and then players reassemble the artist's fragmented memories into a final, lasting legacy, a loving gift to his granddaughter. Next up is a beautiful interior scene. The artist has really showcased a stunning interior here. The layout is well-balanced, and they're leveraging ray tracing to really make it pop. Nice work. And last but not least is Lux. This project from the University of Hertfordshire is a final year project made by two students with a little help from freelancers. Lux is a local co-op puzzle game. What you're seeing here is a vertical slice, and I'd say the pair are off to a fantastic start. Thanks for joining us for our news and community spotlight. Have a great week.